Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let me show you how to create an alarm clock using Automator and the Calendar app on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, if you've ever tried to set an alarm on your Mac, you know it can be kind of frustrating. If you ask Siri, you won't get any help. Set an alarm for 1 p.m.
I can't set an alarm here. How about a reminder instead?
And of course you can set a reminder, but a reminder is going to give you kind of a quiet notification with the little thing at the top right hand corner of your screen. That's fine for getting a notification while you're working, but if you're in another part of the room or taking a nap, it's not going to wake you up. Now there are other ways to set alarms on your Mac. For instance, you can get a third-party app to do this in the App Store, but these either cost money, bug you for in-app purchases, or show advertisements in them. So another thing that you can do is you can go into the calendar, and in the calendar you could set an event to happen at a certain time. And you can even associate a sound with that event. But sometimes you may have the volume on your Mac set too low for that to actually work. And it's kind of clunky to constantly be setting these events in the calendar. So let me show you an easier way you can do it using the calendar, but also using Automator. And setting this up the first time is going to have a lot of steps. But once you have it set up, I'm going to show you how easy it is to then reuse that alarm easily. So let's start off here in Automator. And I'm going to use the calendar alarm here. So let's choose, and I'm going to look up JavaScript, because I'm going to use JavaScript instead of AppleScript like I always do, and use Run JavaScript here to write a simple script that will work in Automator. You'd think there'd just be some Automator actions you could add that would play a sound, but that's not the case. You could have some music played in the music app. It's kind of clunky. So instead, let's have it done here with JavaScript. Okay, so here's my script. You can see I start off here with the regular function declaration, and then I use app equals the current application here, just to give us something to trigger these things, and include standard edition so we can do a lot of scripting with this app. Now we're going to get the original volume, so the volume where the system preferences are set right now. That way we could set it back to that later on. Unfortunately, the volume settings output volume gives us a number between 0 and 100 instead of up to 7. So to get a number between 0 and 7, we divide by 100 multiplied by 7. And then we go and we set the current volume all the way up to the top to 7. Then we're going to display a notification. I like displaying a notification instead of using something else to trigger the sound because it puts something visual on the screen and it's simple and easy to do. I'm going to just call this notification alarm clock. That's all it needs to show there. And I'm going to set it to the sound rooster. Now, where's the sound rooster? Well, in the Finder, if you use the Go menu here, hold the Option key down and go to your user library. So this is not your system library, but your user library. You'll find a folder called Sounds. If it's not there, you can always create it. In there, you'll find anything you've added as a custom system sound. So I put a file in there called rooster.m4a. It's a simple little rooster sound. And if this was a AIFF file, it would actually appear in System Preferences. Since it's not, it won't appear in System Preferences as an alert sound, but I can still use it as a notification sound. So then after showing the alert with that sound, it's going to wait 3 seconds. Why? Well, we're going to set the volume back to the original volume. If we do that immediately, then you only hear the sound played at the original volume. You want to delay 3 seconds, give the sound some time to play before going back to the original volume. So let's give this a test run here. I'm going to use the Run button and you could see the alert show up. Great. So let's save this. When I go to Save, since I made this a calendar alarm in Automator, it's going to say Save Calendar Alarm As, and I'll just call it Alarm Clock and Save. Then it's going to launch the calendar app and it's going to play it right away. Notice what it did here. It created an Automator calendar here on my Mac. That's because, of course, syncing these to the iPhone or something would be useless. There's no Automator there. So this is just going to run on my Mac, which is perfect. I don't want my alarms going off on all my Apple devices. This is an alarm I'm making for my Mac. Now, in this Automator calendar is this alarm clock here. It's just this one event, an entire calendar for one event. Great. I can go into the alarm clock here and I could see there's a time for this alarm. So I'll change it to something in the future. And now I can quit calendar, I can quit automator. And when the clock strikes 12:03, it should give me that alarm, which is going to be a notification including that sound. And there you go. You see the calendar notification and the notification coming from the automator action there. Now you may be saying, boy, that's a lot of steps to set an alarm on a Mac. But you only have to do most of those steps the first time you set this up because this isn't going anywhere. You could see it's still here set for that time. So if I want to use the alarm again, all I need to do is change the time for the alarm. So I could set it to another time. To just keep moving this forward in time using it whenever you need to. You could even get rid of this display notification and instead have it speak something. Something like this. So now when you run this,
wake up.
You get a bit of synthesized speech instead and you could set this to whatever you want. You could have it even loop here. So I've created a simple little for loop to go 3 times, speak something, delay 3 seconds, and then it would speak it again and do that 3 times and then set the volume back at the end. And you could add a using parameter here to have it speak with one of the other standard voices.
Wake up.
So that could be handy for some people. It's not ideal. I wish Apple would at some point in the future add a full clock app with an alarm to the Mac. Maybe we'll see that in an upcoming version of macOS. Thanks for watching.
If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.